sick, huh? You are?
So, my name is Elroy.
Elroy what?
Elroy Fernandez.
Elroy, you've come all the way from Bali for this program on plants.
Yeah, yeah.
Tell us, this is Abgini. Tell us about yourself.
So, about myself, I'm just like any ordinary person, actually. You know, like every...
Based in Spain for a long time.
Huh?
Based in Spain?
No. I've not been based in Spain. I've been based in Goa. But I've actually traveled to like North India a lot. And I've traveled also out of India.
Your
a little
is,
bit.
Is, has been
communication.
And before that programming.
Industrial. Yeah, and before that, I was doing web programming, mainly WordPress.
I see, WordPress.
WordPress based.
They have a WordPress group in Goa. But
they have a WordPress group in Goa. They do little.
Yeah. You were talking about Nalanda, which I found interesting.
Yeah, yeah. So basically, the Nalanda University that existed in India, their understanding of the mind and emotions compared to modern day psychology is kindergarten level compared to the Nalanda. This is widely accepted by all scholars, basically. What's actually unique about the
sorry. Oh, here. Sorry for the interruption.
Why take interest in this, right? Because the thing is,
yeah.
Is nowadays what is happening is that our education system is actually based on accumulation of wealth, and when we accumulate more wealth, we are supposedly
happier.
Yeah.
Supposedly.
Yeah. But what happens is that as per the Nalanda tradition, happiness has got more to do with balancing of emotions and mental states. So how do we do that? What are the different types of emotions that a human being can experience, right? And which are the positive emotions, which are the negative emotions? How do the emotions work? Like anger, most of the people think like, you know, anger is good, you know, it's good to get angry, you know. But anger, as per the Nalanda tradition, has a tip of honey, but a root of poison. Very rarely, after you cool down from anger, are you not ashamed of your actions while you are angry? So how to deal with that? Then what are the positive emotions? Compassion. Why compassion? Compassion, as per modern day, is compassion is looked at as a weakness. Right? You know, there's a saying that scratch the compassionate person and see the hypocrite, something around that line. But actually, the thing is because of wrong understanding of compassion, wrong practice of compassion. When we realize that by us being compassionate to other people, how it benefits us. When we realize that, we see the logic behind it, and we have the right amount of compassion, we start to see the benefits. Then
we do it for ourselves also, in that sense.
There's a saying from the Nalanda tradition: be wisely kind to yourself. Be wisely selfish. Don't be selfish like a foolish person. Be wisely selfish. So because being compassionate, being generous, is good for you, that is why you should do it.
Yeah.
You know? So why is it good for you? So then actually it's an entire, you know.
So you went pretty deep into this, Elroy. How did it trigger off? What interested? What drew your interest?
I saw somebody like who I thought his way of being was very unique. His the way he carried himself and me, who was kind of like, you know, really into like everybody, really, you know, and even now also, you know, enjoying like sense pleasures, like good music, good food, you know, good everything.
Yeah.
You know, nice atmosphere and all. But I noticed that this person who didn't have much he seemed much happier than me at that moment. So I was curious, and then, you know, investigating and then figuring out, okay, what what actually made him happier is because he understands emotions and he understands mind. And then where did he learn this from? Because it's something you need to learn, right? Unless you learn something, you don't know it. So then, you know.
So you studied entirely in Goa, or you were born elsewhere or came to Goa? What?
So I have actually passed my 10th. So I've not passed my 10th. I just learned from different people.
Self-learned.
But I have done a systematic training in Nalanda tradition.
I see.
So I have a diploma in it.
I see.
But I'm not the smartest in my class. You know, there are other much more smarter people.
So online or offline trainings are.
So the diploma that I did was actually online. We had a class like 5 hours a week. So it was very little. 5 hours a week is nothing. But then also my own interest, obviously I traveled to meet many people who were very accomplished and studied under them.
Very interesting.
Yeah, but studied only little, I didn't do systematic.
Tell me about programming and about web programming and
information. So about web programming is I had actually got into WordPress initially just to make websites for myself. And then I realized that there was a big niche in actually WordPress, and so just like, you know,
this is which point of time?
This was about like maybe 10 years back.
I see.
10 years back, making teams, you know, it was
making teams
because at that time
it was new and it was not very user friendly.
And
all WordPress sites look the same.
Yeah, you could quickly spin up a site,
right?
You know, so that was a way.
Very interesting. And what are your future plans? Plans interest you?
I don't know about the future because
pandemic.
Future is dynamic. Right?
Yeah.
So the thing, I don't know actually. Maybe, you know, study more. This is actually the one thing is that the knowledge, the government cannot tax you for the knowledge.
on that high note, we will leave it. But it's interesting what you say. Thank you.